Hi everyone, my name is Will Valida. I'm a software engineer and cloud architect. And in this video, we're going to talk about building natural language processing applications using Azure OpenAI. Azure OpenAI provides developers with the ability to add AI functionality into their applications. Azure OpenAI has various models available for us that we can use for a variety of different tasks. So in this video, we'll talk about what models are available to us, how we can use prompt engineering to improve responses from our models, and how we can provision a model in Azure OpenAI and then use it in our applications. To build apps with Azure OpenAI, we need to choose and deploy a model. There are several base models that come out of the box, and we can fine-tune our models to create customized models. Azure OpenAI includes the following model types: GPT-4 models, which are the latest generative pre-trained models that can generate language and code completions based on natural language prompts; GPT-3.5 models, which can generate natural language and code completions based on language prompts as well; and the GPT-3.5 Turbo models are optimized for chat-based interactions; embedding models, which convert text into numeric vectors and are useful in situations where we need to compare text sources for similarities; and finally, DALL-E models. These models are used to generate images based on natural language prompts, which are currently in preview in Azure OpenAI. I like to use these to generate images for my social media and blog posts. Each model family performs different tasks well, and each model within each family has different capabilities. We can break down the model families into three main groups. The first is text or generative pre-trained transformer, or shorthand GPT. These models understand and generate natural language and code, and they're great at general tasks, conversations, and chats. The second is code. These models are built on top of GPT models and are trained on millions of lines of code. These models can generate and understand code, including interpreting comments to generate more code. And then finally, embeddings. These models can understand and use embeddings, which are a special data type that we can use in machine learning models and algorithms. Now, how the input is written, it plays a large part in how the AI model will respond. For example, if we provided a prompt with a simple request, such as "What is Azure OpenAI?", we'll get a generic answer similar that to an answer we'd get using a search engine. However, if we gave it more details about what we want in our response, we're more likely to get a specific answer. Let's take the following prompt as an example. What do you think the category will be for our second headline? It's likely that our category under the headline will be filled out with the value of business. Try to be as specific as possible about what you want in the response from the model, and you might be surprised how insightful your model can be. Now, just a quick note before we dive into our demo. It's never safe to assume that answers we receive from AI models are correct or factual. Teams or individuals that are developing and deploying AI systems should work to identify, measure, and mitigate harm that our responses from AI models could produce. It's your responsibility to verify any responses from the AI model and to use it responsibly. With that in mind, let's see how we can provision a model in Azure OpenAI and then use that model inside our application. Cool, so let's build an application that uses Azure OpenAI models. So in this demo, what we're going to do is we're going to deploy an Azure OpenAI model and then generate responses from it using the SDK. So here I am in Azure OpenAI Studio, and this is kind of like an overview tool which I can use to have a test with some models, provision models, call deployments, upload my own data, supply content filters, etc. So the first thing we're going to do is create a deployment, and that's where I'm going to select a model. So if I go into models first, when we select a model, we can see which family it belongs to and what capability it has by its name. So here we've got the chat. Here we've got the GPT 3.5 models, GPT-4 models, also embedding models down here. And all of these different models have different capability levels and named differently depending on their capability. So to deploy, manage, and explore our models in Azure OpenAI Studio, What I can do is I can click on deployments here, and let's create a new deployment for a model that we're going to use in our application. Here I've got some existing ones already, but we're going to create one from scratch. So to do that, I'm going to click on create new deployment. And the first thing I want to do is select a model. So I'm going to choose the GPT 3.5 Turbo model. I can also specify which version of the model I want to deploy as well. So they can actually pin a model to a specific version, or I can just select auto update to default, and I'll do that. I can also specify the deployment name, and I'll just call it WV, my initials, the name of the model, and then dev. And this is how we'll reference this model within our code. So if I click on advanced options, we can apply content filters. We can apply a limit on how many tokens per minute we want our deployment to generate. We can also enable a dynamic quota. So if we have some requests that exceed this amount, we can actually, we can exceed that amount if we need to. For this, I won't need to, so I'm just going to go ahead and disable that. And then I'm going to click create. And that's going to go ahead and create my model. And there it is. So now that our model is available, we can actually consume it inside our code. So what I'm going to do is just go into my Visual Studio. And here we're going to be using the C# SDK. Now, Azure OpenAI models can be accessed either through the REST API or by using Python or C#. And to get started with C#, we need to install the following NuGet package. So I'm going to go into my NuGet here, and I'm going to search for Azure AI OpenAI. And I think if I just include pre-release, because it's not quite released yet. So there we go. Just click install. And once that's installed, we can actually initialize our OpenAI client and start to work against our model. So that's been installed. So if I go into my program.cs file, what I'll do is just get some real estate going. Let's write some code. So first things first, I'm going to initialize my Azure OpenAI client. And I'll just add the using in there. I'll just make this client, call a new OpenAI client. And there are two things I need to provide. So the first thing I want to provide is my endpoint. So that OAI endpoint, if I can spell. I'm loading that from configuration. So I've got an appsettings.json file, and I'm using an iConfiguration object to load that file into this application rather than hard coding the values. And now I'm going to use an Azure key credential using my OpenAI key. Let me just clear this up and import that using space there. There we go. Fantastic. Cool. So now what I want to do is build a chat completions object, and I'll explain what this does in a little bit. So I'm going to need a chat completions options object, call it chat completions options. And in here for the messages, I will create a new chat system request system message. Say you are a helpful assistant. Then I'll create a new chat request. Let me just turn that into a comma. User message saying, summarize the following text in 20 words or less. Also specify some max tokens, so I'll say 120 tokens. Specify the temperature, so I'll say 0.1 for now. And then the deployment name will be the name of the model that I provisioned earlier. Cool. So let's break down this code and just see what I've written so far. So first up, to make authenticated calls to Azure OpenAI via the SDK, we're going to need the endpoint and also the API key. So when I've initialized my client here, that's what I've provided. And we also need the name of our model here. So in this chat completions options object, I've specified the name of my model. So whenever I make a request, it's going to be using that model. Now, with the client, we can use different endpoints for different models, and some endpoints can only be used for certain models. So here we've got our chat completion endpoint. So this model will take input in the form of a conversation, and we define the roles of the message they send. So I've defined a system message and a user message as well, but they're different types of roles that you can do within chat completion's endpoint. And essentially what we've done here, we've told our system that they are a helpful assistant, and our user has told the system to summarize our input in 20 words or less. Now, we've also defined these properties here, so max tokens, temperature, and deployment name. We know what the deployment name is, but the max tokens is a limit on the number of tokens per model response. The API supports up to a maximum of 4,000 tokens between the prompt and the model response. And you can think of one token equally being roughly being equal to four characters in an English text. And now we've also got the temperature as well. And this controls the randomness of the response. So the lower the temperature, the more repetitive and deterministic our responses will be. So I've set this quite low. So we're going to get a very predictable response. But the higher the temperature we set, the more unexpected our responses will be. So what I've got here in my solution or my project, I've got this text file that describes the process of making pizza. And what I want to do is just basically get Azure OpenAI to summarize this in 20 words or less. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a new variable called text, and I'm just going to read the context of this file. Super simple. So pizza making process, it's just a text file. And then pass that through to my user request plus text. Cool. Awesome. So now what I want to do, we've set up our Azure OpenAI client. We've also set up the chat completions options. So what we want to do is now send our request to our Azure OpenAI model. So to do this, we can use chat completions object to capture the response. And on the client, get chat completions method, passing the chat completions options. There is an async method that you can implement for this as well, but I'm just going to use this for now. And then I'm just going to get the content of the message by getting the response choices message content. There we are. And then I will write that out to the console in a summary. So what I'm now doing is I'm making a response to my Azure OpenAI model, and I'm essentially going to take this text file, and we want to summarize that in 20 words or less. So let's give that a run. And there we go. There's our summary. So learn how to make homemade pizza with this basic recipe and guide, including instructions for making the dough, sauce, and assembling the pizza. Now, I'm going to run that again. Remember, we talked about temperature and how that controls the randomness of the response. So the lower the temperature will be, the more predictable and deterministic our responses will be. So, yep, there we go. Our response is exactly the same. So what I want to do now is actually increase this and make this a little bit more random. Now, this value needs to be between 0.0 and 1.0. So let's crank it up to the max, 1.0, and let's run it again. So hopefully we should get a new response. There we go, guide to on how to make homemade pizza, customize your favorite toppings. Let me run that again. learned to make homemade pizza with this basic recipe and guide, and third time's a charm. And there we go, make homemade pizza with dough, sauce, and toppings. Mix dough, let it rise, add sauce, cheese, and toppings. There we go. So as you can see, because we've increased the temperature in our chat completions endpoint, we get different outputs each time we run it. So hopefully you can see that Azure OpenAI offers different models for text, code, and embeddings, which we can use in this using the SDK. This is the C# SDK. This is a very small code example of how we can actually use C# to build natural language processing applications using Azure OpenAI service. So that wraps up this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, give it a like. If you have any questions, pop them in the comment below. And if you want to see more videos on Azure OpenAI, don't forget to subscribe. No matter where you are in the world, I hope you're having a great day, and we'll see you all next time.